Hey, ladies and gentlemen, this is Amy from Mount of Olives Ministry. Before we get started, I'm going to say a prayer real quick. I plead the blood of Jesus Christ to cover this ministry, the viewers, and the body of Christ. I've asked the Lord to please form a hedge of protection with his angels and the blood of Jesus Christ, and I rebuke any demons, any false spirits, any human servants or allies working through these false spirits. In King Jesus Christ's name, I rebuke them. I bind them in King Jesus Christ's name, and I bind and shatter any prayers spoken against me, any demonic tongues, counterfeit tongues, evil potions, evil works, evil powers, occultic powers, spells, curses, demonic bondages, all bondages, demonic soul ties, all strongholds that are not of God. I rebuke it and bind it and shatter it in the name of King Jesus Christ. And I pray that the Lord, excuse me, I please summon the holy angels of the Lord to please protect my ministry, me, my home, my finances, my employment, my house, my family, my loved ones, every aspect of my life. I ask the same thing for the viewers and the body of Christ. Glory and praise be to God. In King Jesus Christ's name I pray. Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, there's some interesting developments in the peace deal. I have left an article attached below. President Abbas of the Palestine's nation, Palestine state, basically reiterated the statement that Netanyahu reiterated. Now, I'm paraphrasing here, but basically they feel that they don't have to do what America wants, that they can present their own terms. With that being said, Palestine leader Netanyahu seeks NATO force in future state. And I'm going to read it to you. 6 months into, I'm going to read clips of it. 6 months into peace talks dominated by discussion and security, President Mahmoud Abbas of the Palestinian Authority has proposed to Secretary of State John that an American-led NATO patrol, I'm sorry, NATO force patrol a future Palestinian state indefinitely with troops positioned throughout the territory at all crossings and within Jerusalem. Mr. Abbas said in an interview with the New York Times at his headquarters here for the weekend that Israelite soldiers could remain in the West Bank for up to 5 years, not 3 as he previously stated. So he extended the term from 3 to 5 years, and it's like he, I'm not advocating for this president, okay? Because I love Israel. Bottom line, I love God's land, and I don't want God's land divided. But the bottom line is that as it is written, Daniel 9:27 prophecy is going to be fulfilled one way or the other in God's timing. And the other terms is not 3 as we previously stated, and the Jewish settlements should be phased out of the new Palestinian state along a similar timetable. And then since Palestine said he would not have its own army, only a peace force, so the NATO mission would be responsible for preventing the weapons smuggling and terrorism that Israel fears. For a long time, whatever they want, not only on the eastern borders, but also on the western borders, everywhere. Mr. Abbas said of the imagined NATO mission, the third party can state, I'm sorry, can say they can state to reassure the Israelites and to protect us. I'm going to impose U.S. infringements law. Hope I got this right. The copyrights law. This is being used for educational purposes, and the source of this is the New York Times, and I'm going to leave the source below. And also, this article was published on the Jerusalem Post online. You guys can Google that whenever you get a chance. Palestine, Abbas, President Abbas, goes on to say that Palestine will be dematerialized, so they won't have a military. Basically, the NATO forces would be responsible for carrying out any security or protection. Let's see here. It says Mr. Abbas's proposal comes at a sensitive stage of the American brokered negotiations. Mr. Kerry is preparing to present a framework of core principles for a peace deal, including a security plan, a border roughly along the 1967 lines, Palestine recognition of Israel as a Jewish state, and Jerusalem as a shared capital. So, they're presenting their own framework, President Abbas. they're not necessarily going with what America wants. Let's see, and this is a specificity of the framework and how the Israeli and Palestinian leaders express reservations to it will likely determine whether the talks continue past the April 29 expiration date. One possibility, according to several people engaged in the process, is to extend the negotiations through 2014. So those of you that started banking on the fact that this peace agreement was going to be fulfilled in April, you do not know that. This should teach you a lesson, never ever to state something like that as fact, because that is a pivotal role in biblical prophecy. Okay? That is like major, because when that happens, it ushers in the 7-year tribulation. And my son's with me, he's only 17. And Marcus, what happens after the tribulation?
What I believe is like wrath pose on the earth.
And the day and terrible day of the Lord. Yeah. That's what we believe. We're not stating it as fact. But it says it in the book of Revelation, am I right?
Yeah.
Again, the Lord works on his own timing. So that's the possibility. If they don't finish the peace agreement by April 29, they're going to extend it all the way through April 2014. With Israel, the other terms is Israel has to agree to freeze their settlement construction plans in areas that are in this, that are negotiation for this peace agreement, that are to become part of Palestine under the framework. Let's see what else. Mr. Abbas goes on to say, it's not a sacred date. Suppose by the end of 9 months we got something promising. Shall I stop? I will not stop. If after 9 months we didn't get anything, if there is nothing on the horizon, we will stop. So what he is saying is if they don't reach a peace agreement and there is nothing on the horizon after the deadline, okay, it's not a sacred date. If there's nothing resolved after April, and if there's a possibility that they're going to stop the peace proceedings. Now, this is not something I'm stating as fact. This is my observation, okay? Let's get that straight. If they extend it through the end of 2014 and they don't have any progress, then it's a possibility they're going to stop the peace agreement. That is strictly on the Lord's timing, not man. So please, let's not keep concentrating on the peace agreement. I hope this helps to clear things up. I want you to take this to the Lord in prayer and ask him about it. You'll probably get, he'll probably refer you to Acts chapter 1, verse 7. It's not for man to know the season or times of things. But if you want to take this to the Lord in prayer and ask him if this is valid, basically the point of this article, I believe, okay, is that although Kerry is trying to force this agreement down Netanyahu and Abbas's throat, because that's what he's trying to do, okay, their framework, America's terms, doesn't necessarily mean it's going to work out that way. God controls all, okay? Now, this is an interesting part of the article, but Mr. Abbas also distanced himself somewhat from Mr. Kerry's framework, saying he has the right to do whatever he wants, and at the end, we have the right to say whatever we want. So he's saying in that statement right there that America can come up with a framework of their own. It doesn't necessarily mean that Israel and Palestine have to agree with it. They can come up with their own terms, you know. This echoed the statement last week by Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu of Israel. This is, I'm reading this, paraphrasing word by word, that I'm reading it verbatim, that Israel does not have to agree with everything America presents. So they don't have to agree with what America presents. So America can come up with any tactic that they want. They are playing with fire, bottom line, that they're trying to divide God's land. Straight up. They're playing with fire. Hold on 1 second, guys. Could you close the door for me real quick? This wicked nation is playing with fire when they are messing with my God, Jesus Christ's land. So you want to go ahead and play with fire? Go right ahead. It strictly says in the Bible, and I'm paraphrasing, if you divide Israel, the Lord's going to divide America. Right, Marcus?
Yeah.
And you're going to pay a very, 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 very severe price. You forcing God's hand even contemplating this. But anyway, The rest of the article says Mr. Netanyahu's office refused to respond to Mr. Abbas's comments, but the idea that Israel can rely on its own military, not a third party, is a standard trope of the prime minister's. So there's an indication here that Israel wouldn't have any type of third-party military presence or protection. They'll have to rely on their own, basically leaving them open for, you know, any foreign threat. But you know what? God's got Israel's back. So Israel's not alone and Israel's not unprotected. He also said, and I'm going back to the article, he also says a fixed timetable is untenable, citing the volatility in the region. Our attitude toward international forces is skeptical and in the extreme, says one senior Israeli official. Timing can't be artificial. It has to be based on performance, and we want to be able to judge what's going on with the performance. So, you know, this went back and forth. Jane Paskey, Mr. Kerry spokesman, said in an email that there are many ideas being proposed back and forth, basically between the Israelis and the Palestinians, to make any predictions about the final contents of a framework. So it is a very pivotal role. There's progress being made, you know, but it's a gradual process, and it's going to be on God's timing. But rest assured, Daniel 9:27 is going to be fulfilled. When it's fulfilled, America is going to pay a very heavy price. Let's see. Here's another interesting part. Others brief on the negotiations said the secretary was trying to bridge the gap on security by pressing Mr. Abbas to extend his time frame and by urging Israel to allow the United States, possibly with Jordanian involvement, to assess the conditions for withdrawal. They haven't found a balance point yet. I'm just kind of going through the article, the rest of it. I'm not going to read the whole thing. You know, I'm going to let you guys read it in the link. It goes on to say that the U.S. understands Israel's position. How many times the U.S. stabbed Israel in the back? There was an article not too long ago that Israel did some type of an airstrike. You remember that airstrike?
Yeah.
Well, who's it on? Was it on Syria?
I don't remember.
I believe it was on Syria or the Gaza Strip. I'm not sure. But the United States blew the whistle. They told the media, and the media told the public. And the United States had to have known that the media, they got big mouths, that they was going to just basically reveal that to the public. But then again, mainstream media is the puppet of, you know, the Illuminati and United States, this whole government, this whole world satanic. Let's see. I'm going through the rest of this article because I'm going to let you pretty much read it. So they still want to get it back to the 1967 borders. You know, bottom line is Israel's going to become more isolated. So, let's see here. So that's where this peace agreement is at right now. You know, and here's the interesting part, the way the article ends. We all have to address, first of all, Mr. Netanyahu, the president said. Mr. Netanyahu is the key. If he does believe in peace, everything will be easy. So it's like, you know, it's like they're saying, you know, putting the pressure on Israel again to sign this peace agreement. All right, guys. I'm going to leave the article link below. It's going to happen, Daniel 9:27, in God's timing, not man's. But it's interesting development that they're stepping away from America's framework, and they're going to try to devise their own. All right. Marcus. All right, you all. I'm going to wrap this up. You guys have a blessed day. The article is in the link below.